Welcome to the home of contagious encouragement, Keep the Faith. Hi, I'm Donna Cruz.
And I'm Keith Stevens. No matter where you are in life right now, it's always a good moment for a little bit of hope or a lot of hope. On Keep the Faith, it all sounds something like this.
My God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion.
There were moments in my life that were pushing against me, and they were making me feel uncomfortable and going through those hard times, but God was always there. So those two hard times that I've been through were inspirational.
Do you have a song, or could you write a song like this? And he just started describing, literally describing this song to me sonically. And I was like, I might have something already. Can I play it for you? And it was just that sort of perfect moment.
Antonio Sabato Jr. is in the new movie, God's Not Dead, We the People, and shares about how his faith has seen him through difficult times. That's next on Keep the Faith.
Forever defeated, now is
contagious encouragement on Keep the Faith.
I've heard them say before to live just like you're dying, yeah. Wish I could say that's how I am, but I've been lying, yeah. Lying in my bed at night one too many times, I'm thinking, what if, what if? My biggest fear is waking up to find what matters is miles away from what I spend my life chasing after. Is my story gonna have the same two words in every chapter? What if, what if? But last I checked, this heart inside my chest is still beating. Well, I guess it's not too late. What if today?
Listening to Keep the Faith.
Hi, I'm Keith Stevens. In difficult seasons, what serves as your anchor? After immigrating to the United States, Antonio Sabato Jr. has built a life for himself as the owner of his own film studio. He likes to get in front of the camera too, starring in TV shows, videos, and movies like God's Not Dead, We the People, in theaters tomorrow through Wednesday.
You know, the hardest times in your life you think are going to last forever, but they don't. And God puts you through them to really see what kind of individual you really are, and to have that trust and that belief and that faith into God that things are going to be fine. What doesn't break you makes you stronger. And certain times in my life, you know, whether it was a divorce in my life or whether I was going through some personal things in relation to acting and the business and things that I've done in the past that were tough. It's just, you know, I don't like to talk about things as, you know, they were downfalls for me. There were moments in my life that were pushing against me and they were making me feel uncomfortable and going through those hard times. But God was always there. It goes back to that relationship. I think for me, since I was a little boy, I always had a really strong personal relationship with God. So those two hard times that I've been through were inspirational, you know, and I'm still standing here. And I think that faith is really everything you got, and money or power or friends and relationship can really, you know, touch that, because faith is everything.
My God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion.
Hey, more information about God's Not Dead, We the People, can be found at KeepTheFaith.com. And thanks to Pinnacle Peak Pictures for helping to share contagious encouragement on Keep the Faith.
My heart is breaking in a way I never thought it could. My mind is racing with the question, are you still good? Can you make something from the wreckage? Would you take this heart and make it whole again? Though the mountains may be moved into the sea, though the ground beneath might crumble and give way, I can hear my Father singing over me. It's gone. If I'm honest, maybe I've blamed you too. But you would not forsake me, 'cause only good things come from you. Though the mountains may be moved into the sea, though the ground beneath might crumble and give way, I can hear
Well, I look at a lot of people and they're so proud of themselves. And I just told a guy not long ago, I said, look, you won the genetic lottery. Everyone's not that lucky. There's a fine line in the longitude and latitude of the haves and the have-nots. There's just a fine line between the guy driving the really nice car and wearing the nice suit and the man holding the sign at the corner says, I'll work for food. So next time you see that person and you are driving the nice car and have the nice suit on, turn around.
Give me your eyes for just one second. Give me your eyes so I can see everything that I keep missing. Give me your love for humanity. Give me your arms for the brokenhearted, the ones that are far beyond my reach. Give me your heart for the ones forgotten. Give me your eyes so I can see. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
This is Keep the Faith.
There are all kinds of things that can make you feel scared. One man looked his fears in the face without actually looking and ended up on national TV. His story is next on Keep the Faith.
Mm-hmm. comfortable? Are you too scared to move and walk out of this tomb? Buried underneath the lies that you believed. Safe and sound, stuck in the ground, too lost to be found. You're just asleep, and it's time to leave. Come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, the power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? It's the kind of love that washes sin away. Now the door is open wide, and the stone's been rolled aside. The old is gone, the light has come. So come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're hearts. Oh, he's calling us to walk out of the dark. He's giving us new resurrected hearts. Oh, come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, the power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear
you can find hope and strength for a fresh start. Welcome to Keep the Faith.
I can listen to my heart. I can listen to the world. I can listen to my problems. But what I think I need to hear, nice and loud and crystal clear, is about the one who's gonna solve them. Oh. I need something that can fill my soul.
Let me hear a heart set free. Holy Bible to a melody. listening to Keep the Faith.
Hi, I'm Donna Cruz. You can do a lot of things, but not that. Well, maybe you can. Scott McIntyre is a singer and songwriter with a new podcast called Enduring Hope. He and his wife, Christina, share stories and inspiration to help you through hard times. And he's been through some, from kidney transplants to being on American Idol in 2009. Now, lots of people have been on the show, but here's the thing. He's blind. Scary, huh?
Auditioning for American Idol was quite a step of faith for me. I learned a long time ago that people who achieve their dreams are people who are not afraid to take risks. For a blind person, a dream could be crossing the street for the first time. You know, close your eyes, imagine that you're about to cross the street for the first time and you've never seen the other side. You know, you've heard about the other side. People have told you things, but you've never seen it. And there is real danger there if you step into that street with traffic. But at some point, you have to take that step of faith. I think it's the same with American Idol. You know, can you imagine what the producers were thinking when I first showed up with my white cane and no clue how to look, the cameras and the lens? This is a very visual show. And I'm blind, and I'm supposed to connect somehow with the millions of people at home in their living rooms that are watching me, that are supposed to vote for me. So I stepped boldly into that opportunity, and because of that, people all over the world were inspired to rethink what a blind person was capable of.
Scott and Christina McIntyre's podcast, Enduring Hope, is free wherever you get your podcasts. We'd like to thank Artist and Christian Testimony for helping to make encouragement contagious here on Keep the Faith.
When darkness tries to roll over my bones, when sorrow comes to steal the joy I own, when brokenness and pain is all I know, I won't be shaken. No, I won't be shaken. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. She no longer has a place to hide. I am not captive to the lies. I'm not afraid. No, I won't be shaken. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. My fear doesn't stand a chance when I stand in your love. Oh, I'm standing.
emotions are contagious, actually to the third and fourth contact. If I offer hope, not only might my spouse catch it, or my child, or my best friend, but their friend and their friend, and it goes out in ripple effects. It's pretty powerful.
Ain't nothing like a gospel song, makes me wanna sing it all day.
This is Keep the Faith.
Next on Keep the Faith, Francesca Battistelli shares about her song, God is Good, which has been a story years in the making.
Do you have a song, or could you write a song like this? And he just started describing, literally describing this song to me sonically. And I was like, I might have something already. Can I play it for you? And it was just that sort of perfect moment.
Right now I'm staring down a giant. Right now I can't see past my pain. Right now my songs have turned to silence. And you've never seemed so far away. But I still believe there's no high you can't rescue. No war you can't win. No story so over it can't start again. No pain you won't use. No war you won't break through. It might be too much for me, but there is no impossible with you.
If you need to be encouraged, you've come to a good place, the home of contagious encouragement. Keep the Faith.
I've heard you can take what's broken and make it whole again. Well, here's the pieces of my heart. What can you do with them?
'cause I can't have them all together anymore. So I let them fall, surrendered to the floor. You make
listening to Keep the Faith.
Hey, I'm Keith Stevens. You can't be certain of much these days, but one thing is always true. God is good. That's the message behind Francesca Battistelli's new song, God is Good.
Oh, God is good.
It's featured in the new movie that Francesca is starring in called God's Not Dead, We the People, in theaters tomorrow through Wednesday. She shares how the song came to fruition.
I had written it years ago for the last record and really felt the Lord say, this isn't for now, you need to wait. But it's been one of my favorite songs for like 4 years.
We're all young, then we're old. Kids have kids of their own. And the days just keep moving, moving. If there's one thing I know true, wherever I go, He is with me forever through it all.
Second to last day of filming, the director was describing this moment in the film, this montage, and he was like, do you have a song or could you write a song like this? And he just started literally describing this song to me sonically. And I was like, I might have something already. Can I play it for you? Joy comes, tears fall. I'm learning there's beauty in it all. It's not hard to find it. You just have to look. Oh, God is good. And it was just that sort of perfect moment.
Our thanks to Pinnacle Peak Pictures for helping to make encouragement contagious here on Keep the Faith. For more about God's Not Dead, We the People, you can visit KeepTheFaith.com.
Spend today in a conversation in the mirror, face to face with somebody less than perfect. I wouldn't choose me first if I was looking for a champion. In fact, I'd understand if you picked everyone. It's just not my story. True to who you are, you saw my heart and made something out of nothing. So I don't need my name in lights. I'm famous in my father's eyes. Make no mistake, he knows my name. I'm not living for applause. I'm already so.
Every life makes a statement. The only question is, will that statement end with a period? It's over. A question mark, what was it all about? Or an exclamation point? And I think every mom probably dreams that their child's life will end with an exclamation point. Well, if it's going to do that, they've got to launch that child out of a remarkable family culture into a world that's not that way. But having experienced that, that those kids are going to be prepared to go out and make a difference in the lives of others, which will lead to the day at which their life will be celebrated with an exclamation point at the end.
This is Keep the Faith. Keith Stevens on Keep the Faith with an encouraging thought from J.P. Morgan. The first step towards getting somewhere is to decide you're not going to stay where you are.
Abraham, you're the God of covenant and faithful promises. Time and time again, you have proven you'll do just what you say. Though the storms may come and the winds may blow, I'll remain steadfast and let my heart learn. When you speak a word, it will come. Faithfulness to me. Great is your faithfulness to me.
God, from age to age, though the earth may pass away, your word remains the same. Yeah, your history can prove there's nothing you can't do. Your faithfulness.
Faith.
I lived enough life to say help is on the way.
Contagious encouragement is what we do at Keep the Faith, but we can't do it without you. You can call and you can encourage somebody else. We're at 800-726-4150. That's 800-726-4150.
I remember I was going to school, and that time I commuted by public transportation.
Okay.
And so I remember going to school one morning, and I had my Metro card to take. I was in New York to take me to school the morning, but I didn't know how I was going to get home. There was not enough money to take me home the night, and my class ends at 10:15 p.m.
Whoa.
And so at the end of the class, I am like, what am I going to do? Then I felt the urge to use the restroom. And as I opened the door and looked into the stall, there was a $5 bill right behind the silent.
Sparrow's not worried about tomorrow or the troubles to come. The lily's not thinking about the seasons, the drought or the flood. The tree that's planted by the water isn't fazed by the fire. So why should I be? 'Cause you take good care of me. The sun's not worried about the winter, 'cause soon it will pass. The light's not thinking about the darkness or the shadow it casts. A heart that's planted in forgiveness doesn't dwell in the past. So why should I be? 'Cause you take good care.
Carrie.